beginning of the year, back in January, before we got on the air with our shows. Ginger Walt is going to show you the Bambeco Mason Tower Bee House.
Yes.
This is actually a house for honeybees. This is a particular type of honeybee.
Mason bees, not a honeybee.
Okay.
Yep.
So these are bees that are pollinators.
Yes.
These are not scary bees that sting you.
Correct.
This is actually a better pollinator than a regular honeybee. Right?
It is. They actually pollinate versus the honeybee 80 to 1. So for every 80 plants that a honeybee mm-hmm. will pollinate, one mason bee will pollinate.
So you're going to have lots of more flowers and bigger and prettier flowers with these bees in your garden.
Exactly. For those of you who love to do your gardening, but you love the results, you're going to love the results even more if you have one of these organic, beautiful mason bee houses. It's like a habitat for your bee, for your mason bees. You want them around because they are the most prolific pollinators in the world. Mm-hmm. They will, like I said, pollinate 80 to 1 versus the honeybee. They are responsible for 30% of our food supply and 90% of our plants. They're extremely important. So what you're gonna wanna do is when you pull this out of the box, we give you simple instructions.
It's all wrapped around the box.
It's all
around
wrapped,
the house.
Yep, all wrapped around that box.
And it tells you, I think this is, I'm gonna turn this around, Ginger, because
yeah,
I just
sure,
want you to
go right
see
ahead.
On the back. It tells you all about mason bees. Mason bees are not aggressive. And
not
they're
aggressive.
Actually, unlike a honeybee where they all protect the one queen in the beehive, these are very solitary, and
yep.
so each of these female mason bees, her only job is to lay eggs to make more. But
that's it. They pollinate, they lay eggs,
so they don't chase
that's
you around.
No, nope.
I have to tell you, their population is declining, and so this is a really good
that's
way
right.
to protect them. And the instructions are on one side of the card. It tells you exactly what to do.
And it gives you all of the information. Why would you want this? You want this because it's important to our environment. It's mm-hmm. important for you to have. It's important for your kids to learn mm-hmm. too.
Yeah.
The bees they play an excruciatingly, you know, like amazing role for our vegetation, mm-hmm. for having our fruits, our vegetables. Mm-hmm. You want to put this in an area that is going to be about 30 meters away from where your garden, your vegetable garden, or your plants, or your beautiful flowers are. You're going to want to put it up about 5 to 7 feet up high.
Like up on a tree?
Up on a tree,
okay.
Up on a fence, up on a post.
Okay.
Up and out of the way. Once it's there in a secure area, they will come back for generations and generations. There you can see what they do is they grab they grab mud and they pack it in there once they lay their eggs and they keep them in there.
A protective place for
that's
them.
That's it.
And I have to tell you, you don't have to do anything but put it up. Do I put anything in it?
You put nothing in it. They
everything, put all their own stuff in it.
That's it. This is what they love. They love to have that the bamboo. You see the way that the bamboo is on the inside? It's an 8 millimeter bamboo hole, and that is where that's what they look for when they want to lay their eggs.
Mm-hmm.
And this is made out of bamboo, and it's also made out of pine. So it's all completely natural. I love how we have it right there. Be our guest.
Well,
I love that too, because you know this is so important for us to have in our garden.
The habitat for these mason bees is on the decline, so they are becoming quite endangered. So it's nice because their population is disappearing, and they're such great pollinators that
yes.
we help them to be prolific, find
right.
a place to live and lay their eggs and protect them. These are let me reiterate.
Yes.
Non-stinging bees.
That's right. They're not like a wasp.
They're
not like a hornet or anything.
They're not aggressive.
Not aggressive.
They don't care about you at all.
That's it.
They just want to lay their eggs and pollinate the flowers.
That's right. They come out in the morning time when, you know, it doesn't matter what the weather is. From April to June, they're, you know, crazy doing their job. Their mm-hmm. one job is to pollinate.
Mm-hmm.
That is all they do. Then they lay their eggs in this habitat.
And see how that one in that picture
and
is
that one
mud
is
packed in?
That's it.
They fill the mud on top of the eggs to protect
mm-hmm.
the eggs in there.
They protect the eggs, and then the next generation will hatch.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So it's very easy. This is something that is educational for everyone.
Oh my gosh, if you have kids and grandkids.
If you have
how
kids,
cool is this?
Oh my gosh, this is, and it's so important. Mm-hmm. I mean, when I was, I kind of got educated on this a little bit. This is brought to us by Evergreen, mm-hmm. which, you know, they have beautiful things for our garden, but this is one of the essential things that you really need if you're having for the first time, maybe if you're doing vegetable gardens or fruit gardens, or if you have fruit trees. If you have your beautiful blooms,
well,
you want to make sure that they're getting pollinated.
You're doing two things right here. Mm-hmm. You're helping these bees, and you're giving yourself the most beautiful garden you can imagine, because
yes.
they're going to stay around your garden and completely keep pollinating all of your flowers and
right.
fruit trees and other things better than any typical honeybee or bumblebee can do.
Right.
Plus, they don't sting. So they're just going to make your garden pretty.
That's
and
it.
All you're going to do
and
is
leave
provide
you alone.
Some shelter for them. You don't have to put food in it or do anything to it. Just make sure it's placed 5 to 7 feet off the ground and about 30 meters
yeah, right
from
around
your
20,
flower
30
garden.
Meters away from your flower garden. Did you know that, and I, you know, this is all educational for me as well, because I had to learn all about these. 2 to 3 mm-hmm. Female mm-hmm. mason mm-hmm. Bees, they will pollinate one apple tree.
Wow.
Isn't that incredible?
It's
they
amazing.
Are so incredibly efficient that they do, and we talk about 80 to 1 versus the honeybee. So for what 80 honeybees do, for plants,
one mason bee. So
that is incredible.
I think this is a really
incredible.
Cool thing to have.
It is.
So you can get 5 easy pays with your Q card of like $4 and change, or just the $22.84 all at once. But brand new today, and I'm so glad we brought this in.
Me too.
This is the Bambeco Mason Tower Bee House. And you're really doing some good things by putting this in your yard.
Yes,
I
be
love
our
it.
Guest. I love that.
So stay in the ordering
Thank
process
you,
for that. Ginger, thanks for bringing
Thank
this
you.
In.
Thank you, babe.
So I hope you enjoyed our critter show. And if you did, I'm sure we'll do it again. So let us know. And meanwhile, that's going to wrap it up for me. I'm off for the next few days.